In this video, I would like to show you content of my manual for art teachers that I called Elements of Art with God and Heart, discovering elements of art through theology, theory, practice, and project in 8 engaging and equipping lessons. I am teaching 8 elements of art, and you will see this in this wonderful content. Dot, line, shape, form, color, value, texture, and space. And after the content, and acknowledgments of all people who helped me with teaching this art lessons and who was supporting me in prayer when I rolled out this program. I also have testimonials, preface, where I am introducing you to this book. Also, I'm having introduction of Elements of Art with God and Heart program and course to your students, so it will be easier for you to break it down for them. I have 2 tables of lessons from 1 through 4th and from 5th through 8th on objectives, and where I'm giving you more information on which Bible verse I'm using, which objectives belong to each lesson, and the other names for this element of art, art styles that use this element of art, and artists that use this art styles, this art element. I'm also writing in these tables everything, all art supplies that your students will need and you will need as a teacher. I also give ideas where you can buy them. Every lesson starts with this picture. This picture is 1 page from workbook for students. So this Elements of Art with God and Heart manual comes with a workbook for students, but you can order this workbook through Teachers Pay Teachers. And inside of the workbook, which will be in color when you buy it from Teachers Pay Teachers, you will see how I break down each lesson into 5 different steps, and I'll show it to you in a second. Then you can see exactly overview of objectives for particular first lesson, overview of supplies for students for this lesson on that, overview of supplies for art teachers, and then I am breaking it down. First step you will be going through would be the theology part, where the dots came from, how and why God originated dots, and how he used them. Next, in the second part, you will see also how the students will be looking at this from theory part, how this element of art is used in other disciplines at school and in life. Then we will be talking in a second part of theory, how that dot is used in visual arts by visual artists, and all the theory and all the things that you can show to your students about dot and visual arts. In the fourth part, it will be dedicated to practice. So from theology to theory to practicing these dots, using different tools that make big or small dots. And you will be reading all of this and following instructions according to your will. And then the final is the project, how and you can use pointillism style or stippling style or whatever project you will choose to go with. I'm breaking down each project into steps, and you can follow those steps. And at the end, I will show also how cleaning up and bringing snacks that kind of emphasize this element of art is also important if you're capable of doing that. So for every 8 for all 8 lessons, I'm going through all of these parts. And what's the best thing is actually is that your students will get ability and opportunity to create their own in illustrations for the books, right? So remember, this manual for art teachers is black and white, but copy for students is colorful and full color. You can find it on Teachers Pay Teachers. And every time students participate in adding some things into illustration, they will solidify, they will remember better this material, okay? And they also will get a chance to practice on the extra paper. And I am, after doing all 8 lessons, after showing you how to do that, at the very last part of this book, you will see additional information. Three reasons why I teach elements of 8 elements of art, 7 colors of the rainbow, and cyan, magenta, and yellow as primary colors. You will also see a little table with 5 senses that you can also get inside of the workbook for students from Teachers Pay Teachers, which will be colorful, made by yours truly, and how you can adapt this material, everything that I wrote here, how can you adapt to a different, more affordable supply list. For example, you are missionary, you are not able to get all the supplies, you're in different country, you can't get everything, you may be having limited amount of money that was allocated for your art program, go ahead and look through this material on the back, page 85, where I go through every lesson and simplify it, and you show you how you can use regular supplies, pen, pencil, crayons, marker, but teach the same material, though you will have completely different projects, which is totally fine. These projects also, guys, if you will look through projects in the main part, you might, second year be tired of doing the same. This a different supply list on page 85 will show you additional ideas for the projects. After that, I'm giving you general list of supplies for this adapted different budget. Helpful ideas for games and stations and activities. This is awesome information for you guys. I'm giving you ideas for games, stations and activities, books and links for the videos, what you can incorporate, as well as snacks for each element of art. Dot, line, shape, form, color, volume, texture, and space. You will see what else you can add, how you can make it more fun and interactive and interesting for your students. You will be able to understand how you can adopt this for younger students. For example, you want to teach this main lessons, I would say probably would be the best for elementary, like kinder, or first grade through sixth grade. But remember, I taught this program from kindergarten through 12th grade, and I was able to adapt it and make this program more complicated. If I taught younger students, I made this program less complicated, and I add more games and more fun books that related to each element of art. So this all at your disposal, at your consideration, how you want to use it. And at the end, as always, is a little bit about me and everything that I do, and how you can connect to me. Please take a look at this page, because in this page I'm showing you all my social media accounts where you can find me and ask me more questions through my email, website, through Instagram, through Facebook. On Facebook, I have Paper, Paint, and Palette group where I will be talking to people who purchased this curriculum and who would like to know how to use it. Also, there will be additional video about workbook for students where you will see full color copy of the workbook for students that goes along with this manual, that you can purchase this manual on Amazon and Westbow Press websites, and Elements of Art with God and Heart workbook for students you can find on Teachers Pay Teachers in full color. And here, guys, 8 and a quarter by 11 inches 130 pages, guys, for you to improvise, to add another curriculum to your routine that you do at your schools, at your Sunday schools, at your private Christian schools and homeschooling organization. If you need to reach me, please go to paperpeatandpalette.com website. There is also link to my email, or Masha Hamm at paperpaintandpalette.com email address. I can't wait to hear from you. I can't wait to answer your questions and connect more and see how this program can reach people and students and of any ages, of any different background, how you can reach them for Christ. I'm combining Christian faith and building blocks of visual arts in this curriculum. God bless you and have fun.